I'm simulating the class code for you guys, and so you guys have a better understanding of what is actually a one flash to compare to a 2 second on, 2 second off. And those are the ones that get a lot of confusion. You get that one, you're thinking, oh, it's one on, one off. You replace the air movement switch, it does the same thing. You don't have the same problem. So, let's try to quickly remove the air movement switch out of here. Before I do that,
yeah, it's cold. You want me to shut that door so the breeze don't go
through? I'm just saying the same thing, right?
Yeah. Anybody see that light? Right. So you guys saw a light. That was a creeper. Everything's working so far. Now, air movement switch closes, motor shut down. I don't know if you guys can see, but the igniter is glowing orange in the background back there. The igniter is glowing. And your foot is down.
Carl, on that, we'll do the, you know, we'll Google that and see why that keeps getting
logged on.
It doesn't have a barn, it's just, it's generally after we wash the barns, some of the dust from the attack in there.
Okay, doctor.
And all of it towards the winter or something.
Okay. Now, would you guys change regulators out, or would you guys have, you have, yes?
Oh, we change the master.
We change all that.
You can change master.
Not the first stage.
So maybe what they do, Dan, is they get a second stage low pressure regulator, and that's like a Crown one, you know?
Yeah, not a Rego one, yeah.
Rego, and then, but you know, they do require bidding now. So I don't know if you want to go through that trouble or not, but we've been telling people for quite a while, that's really the regulator you need. But I mean, it's a fail-safe. It's good. It'll last for years. You won't have to worry about plugging up soon.
Alright, so now here's what I'm going to do. I'm actually going to close this switch before I cut the heat up to simulate that, okay, the air cooling switch is binding in the closed condition. And now we went back to open. It's going to start off right away with the solid light, but eventually it's going to give you a flat current. Motor never started. By now the motor should start. It never started. There you go. Blank on, blank off, blank on, blank off, right? Now I gave you that 2 second on, 2 second off. The air cooling switch is binding. It's in a closed rate. The board doesn't like that. Alright? So if you come in and you shut the power off, replace the switch, there you go. That's the two confusing light right there. The 2 second on is actually referring to the 50 minutes. One on, one off, one on, one off, and the air coolant already in the closed circuit. So now let's say the switch never closes, the motor doesn't come on. I'll just unplug the inducer terminal. Solid light comes on, indicating that the transformer is working. Board getting 24, starting its process. All right, nothing's happening. Now she gives you a 2 blank. Everybody see that 2 blank? Air cooling switch doesn't close. You can take a look at your motor wire, take a look at your motor, take a look at your air cooling switch. Those will be the components you want to start looking at for that air flow switch. Any question on those two, the two confusing one and the two blank one? Good? The three blank code, we just have to wait 15 minutes and then just gonna try one more time and we'll give you a 3 blank code. So that, when you come in, you can take a look at it, reset the power, see what's happening, see if your ignited blowing, voltage, pressure, make sure you have valve opening, stuff like that. That will indicate to you that you're just a fail, ignition fail. That should both do with the hot surface. You guys have any question, any concern about the hot surface as far as function?